the basis, A basis, of the vector space is a linearly independent set of vectors that span space. Now, what's linearly linear independence mean? Pretty sure we've used the term. Okay, so I'm just going to give you an example. Question, is this a basis of R3? Okay. Well, first of all, is it linearly independent? Okay. Now, if it's linearly independent, that means answer the question. The question of is it linearly independent? The same as the question of does there exist C1, C2 constants such that these two, this sum is zero. Okay? That's what it means. And that means, essentially, is this one a multiple of this one? Because if this plus this equals zero, then this one, for example, would be negative C1 over C2 times this one. That makes sense? Like if 2 times this plus 3 times this is a zero vector, that means 2 times this is negative 3 times this. Which means that this is negative 2/3 times this. It's a multiple of the other one, right? Okay? And it's called a linear combination. Got a linear combination that's equal to the zero vector. Okay? So we test this. Okay? Well, this is equivalent to saying that this, right? It's three simultaneous equations and two unknowns. Okay? Now you can show that that can't be, because it shows you that C1 has to be zero. C1 and C2 can't both be zero, because if they're both zero, of course, it's true, right? Okay? If you solve this, you see C1 has to be zero, which means that C2 has to be zero. Plug zero in here, or here, you get C2 equals zero. Okay? So, That can't be. I mean, C1, this shows that C1 has to equal zero and C2 has to equal zero. Okay? So you can't say that either one of these is non-zero in particular. Okay. Another way to write this is just as a matrix equation with C1 and C2, right? And this is equivalent to the matrix equation 2, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Okay? Make sense? I mean, this is how you write this system of simultaneous equations. You write it this way as a matrix product, and then you can write it this way. Okay? And if you reduce this matrix, okay, you get 1, 0, 0 just by putting this up there, right? And then you can get 0, 1, 0. Okay? And once you've got that, you're going to get 0, 0, 0. And you get that. Okay? So what you need to see is this condition for linear independence can be translated to a matrix equation or system of equations, and then a matrix equation, and then an augmented matrix that reduces down to something that shows you C1, C2. Now you know if you have a 3x2 matrix, that you can't possibly get three non-zero rows on it. But when you reduce it, you're going to end up with a 1, 0, 0, 1 and a row of zeros, right? Which tells you that C1 and C2 would both have to be zero. Okay? Okay. So, these are linearly independent. In other words, you can't do a sum of these that's equal to zero unless C1 and C2 are both zero, meaning these aren't multiples of each other. Okay? So you want to think about that a little bit. So they're linearly independent. So far, we're okay for getting a basis. Okay? But they also have to span the set. Okay? What do we mean by span the set? Or span the space? Oh man, I'm not bored. So I have to do this kind of small a little bit. Okay, that means
is there an office on this hall?
Please do so. It's good for the
building. I'll walk with y'all.
means that for any V in R3, you can get V by adding multiples of these two. Okay? There's a linear combination of these two, which is a multiple of this one plus a multiple of this one. It's equal to that vector. Okay? So, that means, of course, that V is a sum of multiples. Vectors in the set. Now, these are ideas that we've seen. Okay, so put this in different colors so it can be distinguished from everything else since I'm low in space. This means that, well, let V equal the column vector x1, x2, x3. Okay? We find C1 and C2 such that find a C1 and a C2 such C1 times this vector plus C2 times this vector equals this one. Okay? Well, what I want you to do is write that as a system of equations, then as an augmented matrix. So go ahead and do that.